Minecraft is all about adventure and exploration, and that's how it should be. From locating a stronghold to defeating the Ender Dragon to tackling the new Nether, exploring is thrilling in this game. But what if you've tackled all that vanilla has to offer? Perhaps you seek more adventure. Let's take a look into the top 10 Minecraft adventure and RPG mod packs to spice up the game. Without further ado, let's begin. Number 10, Vault Hunters. This RPG-focused mod pack lets players build on their talents and abilities and use over 2 billion different randomized item combinations of armor, weapons, and idols, which can be looted and found from dangerous and mysterious vaults. These items boost the player's stats and attributes, and they make you stronger as you work towards the end goal of completing all 25 unique artifacts and forging them together to finally access the final vault. This pack is based on supporting solo and cooperative play, so it supports multiplayer quite well. Fight through challenging mobs in the vault as you seek out incredible loot and fight tough unique bosses as you take on a new quest. Number 9, Avatar 100 Days. Could you survive 100 days in an elemental world run by the Fire Nation? If you want to try out the Avatar 100 Days challenge, which is a mod pack set in a world overrun by the ruling Fire Nation, the dominant of the four elemental nations across the world. As the new Avatar is born after a landing meteorite, you must rush to master all four elements in order to maintain balance and bring peace back to the world. Number 8, Divine Journey 2. This expert mod pack for 1.12.2 is the spiritual successor for the prequel 1.7.10 pack that came before it. Based on a unique progression line and a higher number of mods than the original, this pack has a huge number of unique recipes, the ability to automate nearly everything in the game and most of its aspects, and the fact that it's an expert pack that offers a higher level of toughness to the game without being grindy, as you'll only have to wait a short time to gather EMC through the Project E mod, which shaves a lot of time gathering resources and makes the game a little bit easier. With over 600 new unique custom items and boasting being the hardest fair 1.12 expert pack with a solid progression line built upon the FTB quest system, this mod pack has over 1600 quests across 30 different chapters. With Divine RPG to bring a new list of dimensions and bosses to fight, and Galactocraft to visit space, there's also custom dungeons added to them also. There's a collection of modular machines for factories and over 5,000 custom recipes. It's safe to say that this pack is the result of hundreds of hours of effort and work, and it's worth a spot on this list. Number 7, Hexit Updated. Featuring mods from the original Hexit mod pack, this pack brings all new dimensions and dungeons to improve the exploration value of the original, based off of nostalgia of the original Hexit pack. This pack is great for those who love fantasy and magic and exploration, as it has a handpicked list of dimension mods with new bosses and structures throughout. There's an improved spawn rate of diamonds too to speed up the gameplay, and you'll find mods like Doom-like dungeons to explore, Chocolate Quest Repoured for even more dungeons, and some dimensions too, namely Atom, which is a desert dimension, the Between Lands, the Aether, Abyssalcraft, and the Erebus for some weird and wonderful tough new worlds to tackle. Number 6, Decimation Realistic Zombie Apocalypse. In a scary but realistic apocalyptic open world, this zombie mod pack throws you into a zombie-ridden environment, where you must survive alone or with others for as long as you possibly can. With events that emerge over time, you'll be pushed to your limits as you survive as a hermit by yourself or broker alliances and join teams to improve your odds. There's hundreds of brand new blocks and zombie-themed props in this pack, as you'll notice them as you locate different camps and settlements and so-called safe zones around the map, where you'll be able to trade with NPCs and just generally steer clear of zombies. You level up skills as you play, as there's many new stats that are upgradable, like the sword and firearm skills, defense, humanity, and medical. Your job is to fend off the invasion of infected, trade and explore the world to plunder it for loot and supplies to survive. Number 5, Forever Stranded. What would happen if you crash landed on a planet with little to see but just sand? You'll have to follow a chain of quests in a completely custom questline to prevent overheating in a harsh new climate, where unpredictable things could happen at any moment. From collecting water to dealing with the intense heatwave to locating food to overcome your vast hunger, this hardcore mode-based map is a big challenge, offering more lives as you progress and a series of obstacles and feats to accomplish along the way. Number 4, Demon Slayers Unleashed. This mod pack is based around the Demon Slayer mod for Minecraft. You must pick your side in this pack, whether you're a a demon slayer or a demon? Will you explore the land fighting demons or prey on mankind as one? Or will you play passively and build up your own civilization and empire? This large-scale mod pack boasts north of 80 plus mods, focusing on the anime of the same name and upon the combat system. There's a lot of building blocks, vanilla additions, and other great mods thrown in here too to mess around with. Number 3, The Kingdom of Doldar. This is based on YouTuber ForgeLab's Medieval Minecraft 100 Days video. This mod pack introduces you to the Kingdom of Doldar, a fictional fantasy RPG world which is set in a dangerous medieval land with many different risks and rewards throughout. This survival-based mod pack has many different exploration opportunities and challenges on offer. You'll explore and discover many terrifying mythological creatures such as hydras, dragons, sea serpents, and cyclops, as well as crocodiles and snapping turtles. There's many different mobs thrown in this mod pack and stuff to find as you traverse through dangerous dungeons deep below and structures across the land where you can find and craft powerful armor and weapons. Number 2, Valhesia 4. Based on Minecraft 1.17, the newest Valhesia installment is a pack with many classic and popular mods from the initial versions and that modders will enjoy playing with. This pack has many different blocks which are based on a series of new materials and color types to make some really awesome builds with. When tackling dungeons, finding buried treasure, or plundering end cities, the artifacts mod will bless you with new powerful unique artifacts which are found as loot. With mine colonies, you can create your own cities that are livable and have their own working citizens as villagers inside. There's a ton of quality of life add-ons and upgrades in here to improve the game and make it easier. Mobs and creatures have received some love, as there's my personal favorite mobs mod, Alex's Mobs, in here too, that will add some friendly and dangerous mobs to the different ecosystems in game, all with amazing animations and every single one having a unique purpose or trait. All of these mods are added to bring a fantasy style gameplay experience with plenty to do. This pack runs on around 4GB of RAM, but it's recommended of a range of 5 to 8GB depending on your settings and resource packs or shaders which you use on top of it. Number 1, the Pixelmon mod pack. This Pokemon fueled mod pack utilizes the highly popular Pixelmon mod for Minecraft 1.12.2 that brings the world of Pokemon to life inside Minecraft. Through the addition of Pokeballs to catch and capture Pokemon in the wild, hundreds of unique Pokemon types spawning across the world in the overworld, duels and Pokemon battles, breeding for standard and legendary Pokemon types, gyms and trainers, trading and healing of Pokemon, and so much more, such as custom plants, creatures and structures based on the video games and cartoon. I've featured this mod a few times on the channel, and the mod pack is basically the mod itself with some other mods thrown in there to make the gameplay experience better. There's also a highly immersive original soundtrack in this mod pack too, as well as biomes aplenty for a range of amazing, different, beautiful biomes to spruce up the overworld with, to make it feel more like a Pokemon world and a little bit different. There's many different utility commands, quality of life mods like the Game Shark mod, which brings a compass for locating drops and items from the main Pixelmon mod, compatibility fixes and patches, and more which is not found in the base mod, as well as some additions like Journey Map for a nice world map to explore the world with and set waypoints. To improve performance, it's best to run this pack with Optifine to make it run more smoothly. And that concludes the top 10 Minecraft adventure and RPG mod packs. For more mod pack videos, check out my channel and also check out the top 10 adventure and RPG mods in the link down below. Let me know in the comments which was your favorite of these 10 mod packs and why, and also let me know if you actually tried any of them out and played them, and just generally what you think of them. YouTube says 97% of you are not subscribed, so if you enjoyed the video, make sure to subscribe and turn on notifications and slap the like button for more Minecraft mod videos like this one. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.